कलेक्टिव लिविंग। लेट अस ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस। कोटिंग द मदर, एंड देयर इज अ मोमेंट इन एवरीवन्स लाइफ, देयर इज दिस मोमेंट व्हेन द नीड फॉर परफेक्ट सिंसियरिटी इज अ डेफिनेटिव चॉइस। देयर इज अ मोमेंट इन द इंडिविजुअल लाइफ, ऑल्सो अ मोमेंट इन द कलेक्टिव लाइफ। When one belongs to a group, when the choice has to be made, when purification has to be done, sometimes this becomes very serious. It is almost a question of life and death. For the group, it must make a decisive progress if he wants to survive. Every man will face a stage in life when he will not be able to survive without the divine. There will be a question of survival at the individual level. Either he will live for the divine or he will perish. Then comes the collective level, whether you will live collectively or will disappear. It is a choice between your existence and the divine work. Till that decisive moment, we keep on refusing. However, once that moment comes, we will be eager to work for the divine. People will be breathless like fish when they are taken out of water, and they will feel breathless if they don't work for the divine. Now, one might say that there is no manpower for work of such dimension. I can foresee people are flocking to do the divine's work. I can see this happening in the near future. Sri Aurobindo says, governments, societies, kings, police, judges, institutions, churches, laws, customs, armies are temporary necessities imposed on us for a few groups of centuries because God has concealed his face from us. When it appears to us again in its truth and beauty, then in that light they will vanish. To understand this, let us take the example of children playing pranks in the classroom, taking the teacher's chair in his absence. Likewise, when this supreme teacher hasn't come, so many people are taking that chair. And once the divine arrives, all these will be emptied.